my world.
Let's make it count.
I must practice tolerance.
Next.
GSL Season 3. Reversal. 2019, Outland GSL Season 3, Codex, Reversal.
Pretty much feels like I don't have a thing to lose. And it pretty much sounds like you think I'm afraid of you.
What is up, everybody? Welcome to another day here of the GSL Codex. We've had some great games so far in the early half of the season, and I think today is going to be no exception.
Yeah, it looks like a pretty interesting group. No Zerg players today.
No Zergs, no.
But that's okay. We have one of the best Protoss in the world, one of the best Terrans in the world, and then a couple of players that are underdogs.
Similar to the group before, this is one where we have players we're really expecting to move on, mm-hmm. and some players we're expecting to be eliminated. If it's not our two top dogs, Classic and Innovation in this group advancing, it'll be a big shock. Again, I don't think they will not advance, but maybe we'll be surprised. I don't know.
Yeah. Well, last season was completely full of upsets, but so far this season, it's been pretty straightforward. Maybe one top class player falling so far in those first groups, only Sue not making it out, but that was kind of considered the group of death so far in the round of 32. So, you know, it's like sad to see him go, but the players that advance, you can't really hold too much against. You can see those results right here. Of course, that was the Group D where Sue fell out. But other than that, I mean, this is like a pretty solid lineup of players, right? Ragnarok and Kira are both on the up and up and have been for a bit of time. And everyone else is really rock solid, with Hero kind of coming back after a long period of not performing as well. Not to say he's going to necessarily get a top eight this season, but he's looking a lot better than previous seasons.
Right. And so, you know, particularly with Classic here, we have an interesting situation for this guy because, as I'm sure many of you know, everybody has to go to the military if you're an able-bodied young man in South Korea, except for us. Besides us being not able-bodied, we're also not Koreans. We don't have to do that. But
also way too old.
But everybody has to do their military service. Classics is just around the corner. So this could be his last GSL Codex, at least for about, I guess, a little bit under 2 years.
Yeah, that's, like, basically certain at this point. And the thing is, he's already, like, a lock for BlizzCon, but he can't actually travel to it. So it's kind of this weird place that he's in right now. We don't even know that he'll finish the season out, but I guess we'll see. We don't know the exact inscription date for him as of yet. That does not stop him, though, from practicing his tushy off and showing us good results, good games for his fans.
So we're going to start today off with two mirror matchups, a PvP and a TVT. Again, we expect Classic and Innovation to go to the winner's match. I think Keen could always throw a wild card out here. Creator is an excellent player, but tends to underperform in high-pressure matches.
Yeah.
That being said, you know, he's been playing for a long time. Sometimes you see these guys who have been grinding and grinding, and it seems like they're going nowhere, and then they suddenly hit their stride. Everything clicks.
Yeah. Yeah. We'll see if he can do that, but the guy he's going up against, I mean, Classic's PvP is monstrous. Really, everything he does is monstrous. He's the best Protoss in the world this year. For half of last year, he was the best Protoss in the world. He's, like, always top 3 to 4, you know? He's been so strong for so long. You've got to keep him as one of the favorites for the season.
Absolutely. Creator, this player has been a fixture in StarCraft II since the very, very first seasons of GSL. He is a valued member of the Jhin'Erik Green Wings. He's a solid player, but he does not deliver when compared to the rest of the Jhin'Erik pantheon.
Was he wearing glasses last season?
I think. Oh, actually, I'm not sure. Maybe he went to contacts. Now he's back with glasses.
Sure. But new haircut, new glasses, new Protoss?
Maybe not. I don't know. We'll see. We're going to start this off on King's Cove, then Acropolis, and finally Thunderbird for the last match. If we go to map number 3, And so this begins our first match here in Group F. Classic versus Creator starts now.
Makers Classic. Jyn Air Green Wings, Creator.
Oh, all right. Cool. You know, definitely you have to look at it as very favored for Classic, but Creator has two of the absolute best Protoss in the world on his team, and he's been showing better games since maybe the second half of last year. He's been climbing his way back up the ranks from someone who rarely gets into Codes to someone who can, you know, make an upset here and there. So, not going to hold my breath, but
I will.
I feel like you're going to hold my breath. That's called murder, Tasteless.
Nice. I was going to make a joke about holding my breath, but I'll just let it go. That's even funnier. Okay, so there's a Creator probe parked adjacent to Creator's main. So this is sort of the opposite of a proxy. This is just hiding. What we're going to assume is just going to be some tech here, probably a Stargate. Meanwhile, similar idea, different location. We have Classic pushed away from his base, and this is what I don't know if everybody calls it this, but the way I think of it is hiding in plain sight. It's kind of out in the open. Mm-hmm. It looks like it's a scoutable area until you really start to map out where scouting patterns go, and occasionally there are just these big blind spots in the middle of the map that can go unattended.
Well, especially that one. You have to, like, walk closer to Classic's main and then go backwards up a hill for no reason to a place that goes nowhere to find something that's barely proxied. So, yeah, it doesn't seem too likely. More likely that Creators will be found, but
now,
we'll see.
Yeah, generally speaking, statistically, players tend to hug the corner of the map when they're doing proxies, especially in PvP, to hide the pylon just on the edge. So that's usually where people scout first. So
you're right. Players tend to do that. Classic, not as much, though. He will put stuff in the middle relatively often, actually.
But this is why I think Creator's proxy is going to be spotted pretty quickly here. As I think the probe
is close, but not...
Oh, yeah, he's sort of gone around
see, he's
this.
Checking the place that he proxied, which is hilarious.
It's projection, man, a powerful thing. So, it looks like that probe is going to be picked off. Scouts, no Nexus.
Not a terrible scout, to be honest.
Not bad at all.
Yeah, worthwhile. Phoenixes are being made for Creator, so if he can stop this Oracle dead in his tracks, he gets actually a pretty decent advantage here. This was an advantage at one point that we would call almost game-ending. Oh my god, get over there!
Okay, Classic's Oracle's on the run. It's now going to get sandwiched between both the Stalkers and the Phoenixes. Recall's coming down here. Damage going down really fast, and it is picked off!
Huge. That is a huge advantage.
Oracle did literally nothing.
And look at the Insta-Nexus, okay?
Yeah.
It's like a chemical reaction almost. Like you can't even measure the time between killing that Oracle with Phoenixes and the Nexus coming up. We don't know what caused what.
Well, what's crazy about this is that, I mean, a Nexus play is almost never a bad idea against Phoenixes, right? They can't pick up the Nexus. But at the same time, the Phoenixes are still going to be able to come in here and try to harass these workers. So it's going to be cool to see how Creator tries to navigate this game. He got a big win early on by taking out the Oracle. The question now is, how does he capitalize on this? Because I think Classic's response is a logical one from here.
Well, Blink both of them, really, when it's Stargate, expansions are very, very smart. But look, if you look at strategically where we're at, the Oracle did zero. Both went Nexus right away. Both are going into Forge right away. And obviously Blink for Classic, right? But Creator's sitting here making the Robo, so we're going to see Immortals from him. If you just like line these both up on paper, the player in Creator's spot normally has a pretty sizable advantage from here.
Sure. There's obviously no way for Classic to try to catch up in any air arms race with enough Phoenixes already out, so that tech option is completely out the window. The question I'm asking is, how is Creator's execution going to be? Because we've had games where, on paper, Creator is certainly in the lead. But when it comes to finishing the job, it's been a little bit harder for him. And I'm not trying to knock on him too much here, but this is Classic versus Creator here. And Classic is in very
good condition. Trying to say, Tasteless?
I'm saying
just say it, Tasteless. Classic, we're ready to hear it.
Classic is basically overall regarded as a better player.
What?
And has had much more success.
This is controversial. You better watch out. I'm talking to a freak of TV management and Blizzard after this.
You're going
okay?
to HR immediately after this.
Yeah. Can you believe
this
you said
that? This is unhealthy for
Classic
the workplace
is
environment.
Classic generally regarded as a better player than Creator.
You know, I had to be pretty brave to put it out there.
No,
but,
you were.
You know.
I wish I could have that type of bravery.
By the way, Blink is almost done here. We have the Robo started for Classic. On Creator's side, the Twilight Council's just started. But obviously, he's already got some Immortals being cranked out here, incrementing out one by one from the Robo.
Yeah, this is a very good spot. He just needs to make sure that things like these two Adepts don't wreck him. And so let's watch these two Adepts wreck him. Oh, my God.
This is what I was talking about.
Oh, my God.
On paper, Creator can be ahead, but I've always wondered this, if Creator has, like, focus issues or more of anxiety issues or what
it's
is.
It's hard to say because he was actually one of the best Protoss in the world in 2012.
Yeah.
He had a great year then. But, like, for instance, that is one of the only things that can happen right now. Like, two Adepts just coming in and killing.
Right.
What else can happen? Right? Like, it's not like he's going to send an Oracle across the map.
Well, certainly Phoenixes can't fly in and kill all his
yeah.
workers, so that factor is gone. The Robo was late, so he couldn't have done a warp in. So, yeah, literally that was the only thing that could have happened. And the funny thing about two Adepts coming into your base is that for the amount of damage it does, it doesn't really cost the other player that much.
Two Adepts are, like, free. It's like two Zerglings.
No, not to mention, it's also, there's low risk involved. They're shading in, so you can always cancel it. So it's unfortunate Creator was not more on top of that.
Yeah. Yeah, it really is. Both sides going for the third Nexus plus two in charge. A lot of gateways being added on both sides. As far as the workers go, we're about even right now. Creator hasn't really been able to do too much harassment with his units, but he basically knows what's going on. And overall, he's building a stronger unit composition right now than Classic. These Stalkers don't scale overly well. But it's not like a huge amount. You know, it's not like 13 Stalkers. It's only
eight, right?
So it's, but that's not as good as if it was only four Tasteless. I just want to point that out.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Elmo, for teaching us numbers.
Like, you see that, how he's only got, like, three Stalkers, Creator does? Oh, that's a great number. Oh, beautiful.
By the way, Zealot Charge is about to finish on both sides. We're ramping up to a big macro game PvP here. It doesn't seem like either player really wants to attack the other one. There's always the question of, you know, can Creator find a good engagement because he does have the three Phoenixes, so he can get some pickups there and maybe disable something. But we don't see anything like that just yet.
It looks like Creator might attack, which I don't think is what you want to do quite yet. I feel like, you know, you can push this a little bit higher up so that it's even more in your favor as Creator, and he actually walks back, so I guess all is well in the world. But at these smaller numbers, the gateway-based army can still really fight against this, and I think you're actually almost looking for a fight, so Creator being on the map didn't make a lot of sense.
Okay, another set of big warp-ins here from Classic. Now, I don't know that he'll be able to break up into that position on the ramp, but this is a great move here by Creator. Two Adepts now shading in here. They already did some damage to the third base. Now they're going to come in here, unfortunately not targeting down the probes, but instead hitting the Zealots. So good defense there by Classic. Now Classic going to try to come in here.
Yeah, hard to imagine this working out. As a hallucinated Immortal in there as well, the two shield batteries doing real work here for
Well,
Creator.
You know, the Archon's got some really good pairings there on those Zealots. I don't know about this angling here. Yeah, I feel like no matter what, this should not be a breakable position here for Classic.
Absolutely
this
not.
Is,
he's got three Immortals and War Prism and two batteries and, like, gateways, you know, a pylon there. Like,
well, I mean, it's just everything about that didn't make any sense.
Well,
I think Classic way overestimating the position he's in. Now he's quite behind. It's 29 army supply to 61, and a third base for Classic that's barely even mining.
Yeah, I guess it actually did get a bit worse from that. But in a way, what he did there, I appreciated slightly, because I think that in situations like this, where you're going to have a hard time the longer the game goes, if you can trade army semi-evenly, you know, if you can just reduce the size of both your armies, that's something you want to do, right? Like, for instance, if you can trade three of your Stalkers for three of his Stalkers, you want to do that. You know what I mean? And if you can trade four Zealots for four Zealots, you actually also want to do that. You want to keep these armies a little bit smaller. But definitely that advantage for Creators is getting significant.
So Creator's now going to push across the map, and I think this should just be a 1-2 punch to victory, right? I mean, there's just more of everything here for Creator. 144 supply to 93. I think he can just barrel into the third here and just squish it, right?
Going up a ramp is always a little bit tricky, but that's a lot of Immortals. It's, you know, 5 Immortals against 1, and that's a pretty good metric for who's going to win this battle.
Yeah, even on a map that really favors holding the third base here, this is just going to be too much. So the overwhelming numbers come in. Creator wins, starting at least the beginnings of an upset Artosis. Creator taking a game off of Classic.
Yeah.
Certainly not the result I think Classic was expecting as we started the day off here.
Is Old Man Army washed up? That's the question on everyone's minds right now. Classic in possibly his last season of Codes for the next couple of years.
How old is Creator? I actually have no idea. Is he
Creator? He's pretty young still.
Is he? Okay, because yeah. Classic's our oldest player here, so you can defer your military service. By the way, apparently they've, I don't know if you read about this in the newspaper, they're trying to raise the minimum wage, and because of that, the job market's been harder to get out here in Korea, so there's more men going into the military now than before. So some of these guys, especially the pros, have been able to defer more easily.
Huh.
But Classic, it appears, is going to be going in there. I was just curious, because I was thinking, wait a minute, Creator's been in this tournament forever as well. When is he going to have to go? Anyways, game 2 is ready on Acropolis. Classic versus Creator. What? Let's go.
Makers Classic. Jyn Air Green Wings, Creator.
Classic wasn't looking super relaxed there.
No, he did look a little bit alarmed. It's always a little bit weird. I have to imagine, I mean, I can't speak from experience, but the idea of having to take this pro gamer hiatus, a forced hiatus, to join the military, you know, and I want to actually kind of go over this a little bit more thoroughly, because this can be a kind of a foreign concept for a lot of people listening. You're not allowed to even make money during this period of time that's not related to the military.
Yeah.
So it's not like you could just still stream on Twitch or something. So
Yeah, and you can't play tournaments. It's...
Right.
You know, that's why a lot of times, like, people don't even know that some of these players are back, where they would be streaming or they would be playing tournaments.
Yeah.
You see this a lot, too, right? Like, right now, Bisou is playing ladder games, but he's not streaming them because he